Now I've got my undercover uniform, I should get to Chan's scrapyard and find a way to join his gang.
Thank you. What's happening?
I love this place.
Okay, then. How is this holding up? We're still a bit too loud on the game front. Minus 21 would be all about right. Let me just adjust this back around. And oh, is someone being run over? Anyway, hello to all. This is the second of the LEGO Silly Undercover streams. And we are off to join a gang to go undercover. Idiotic move for me to have done. Right. Is there another car we can get? Oi. Is it for the whistle again? Actually, no, wait. We can just call something in.
What's up?
I can't wait to start my
We have the bricks, I think, to build this, and if we don't. So we can find some. That's 1,000. That's 1,000. No, wrong side here. It is. Oh, I don't know if you can hear it on the stream, but there does seem to be an echo. And I don't know how to get rid of that at present. Okay, so that one's locked. There's probably no one on here. Yeah. Let's just make a card. Also, just like last time, I am sorry about the bullens being going to be heard. As
police
I'll press them, a lot more clearer than my voice is. Again, I have no idea what it's doing for. It just seems to be something. Well, I've got to try and solve. I'm sorry, find out why it's doing it eventually. But I'm pretty sure it isn't doing it for the first of these. But yeah, Lego City Undercover. My favourite game, until it's going to get dethroned by the Skywalker Saga. There's a lot to like here, including the story. And as you'll see in a bit, we're going to meet one very interesting gang leader.
Hey, Chase. Now you're an undercover detective, I've added a new function to your communicator.
Is it a voice recorder? So I can do private eye style monologues?
No.
I was disappointed, but I decided to hear the lady out.
It's an audio scanner. You just point it at a window and you can hear what's being said inside the room. You'll need to get to a vantage point to use it, though.
It sounded like it might be useful. I thanked the nice lady and set off into the night.
It's the daytime. Good luck, Chase.
Very loud.
I should get to somewhere I can listen out for clues.
No chance.
Why am I phoning you? Because you're late for your interview. Where are you? Oh, you're meant to be at Chan's limo place. Get a move on.
Yep.
Can you believe that? That Bucky Butler guy.
The one who wants to join the gang?
Yeah, he was at the art gallery.
Well, they do have an excellent collection of cubist sculptures.
What does cubist mean?
Yeah, this is very, very, very...
Bucky Butler. Why is that name familiar? I busted that guy, like 2 years ago. If I get him out of the picture, then I can take his place at the job interview and join Chan's gang.
Hey. You can't steal my car.
This is an emergency.
I'm just steal someone else's.
No!
I'm going somewhere over. And I'm going to have a bit of fun before we do the rest. Woo! Super jumping out of the way. Oh, he wanted to be whatever, so he came. So did he.
Okay,
let's just try and break Kai's boat for no reason. Another radio point. So get ready for more completely unnecessarily loud audio. Some of these audio excerpts are actually kind of funny.
What do you think of this one?
You know how they say a picture paints 1,000 words?
Yes.
Well, they're going to have to invent about 999 new ones for rubbish for that thing.
Look at this one. Isn't it weird how his eyes follow you around the room?
That's his job. He's a security guard.
He's so lifelike.
Goodbye, sir. I hope you enjoyed the gallery.
Yeah, thanks. I picked up this real nice print from the gift shop.
Gosh, it looks just like the original.
It sure does. Well, see ya.
I didn't even know the gift shop sold prints.
It's a good job I'm here, because that's an incompetent museum staff member.
Hey, you, stop. I know you. You're that cop from years ago. What?
Oh, way to tip off your target, Chase.
I just want to talk. Keep running after you!
Oh
man, why do you keep arresting me?
You were going to join Chan's gang.
That ain't a criminal offense. Sheesh, I don't like to tell people how to do their own job, but if you're going to arrest me for anything, it should be for the painting I just stole, you fool.
Huh?
Oh, sausages.
Thanks, Bucky. Okay, I better get to my job interview.
Wait to help yourself there, you useless robber. Now we've got to go back to some
police business.
But I'll go back and escape. Yeah. every trick.
You're the new boy?
Yes, sir.
As a girl.
Oh, I was promised a thug. You look more respectable than I was hoping.
Well then,
sorry,
maybe you
that.
Should get some glasses, old man.
Ha ha! That's more like it. Okay, I need you to pick someone up.
Oh, are they feeling sad?
In a car!
Obviously.
The person is Forrest Blackwell.
The multi-billionaire?
That is correct. It won't be easy, though. Mr. Blackwell is constantly hounded by the paparazzi. They will try to follow you. And Mr. Blackwell will not like this.
Got it. Not a problem. Because I am awesome at driving.
Good boy. Go pick him up at Blackwell Tower.
He's
and be
awesome
polite.
At driving.
He's our only customer.
Be based entirely on how I drive.
Mr. Blackwell, are you still thinking about the scandal? Why won't you let anyone in your tower anymore?
Is it true you prefer cats to dogs?
Gentlemen, please, give Mr. Blackwell some privacy. He merely wishes to go somewhere mysterious for secretive reasons he doesn't want you to know about.
One more question, sir. What, where are you going? Hey,
Forrest
Blackwell, sir,
what?
Don't leave me. It's my job.
Talking.
Where can I take you, sir?
Very kind of you to ask, young man. I shall be attending one of the last ever performances of the Perpetual Inbox at the Gillespie Theatre. I trust you have been told of my aversion to the paparazzi.
Yes, sir. I'll do my best to shake them off.
I appreciate that this may require you to adopt a somewhat, shall we say, unorthodox driving style.
It could get a little rough.
Oh, do not worry on my
account.
I have ridden atop ships of the desert.
Beef.
Nothing can compare to the discomfort that inflicts upon one's posterior. Are you a patron of the arts yourself, young man?
Well, I like that TV show with the monkey who solves crimes.
Ah, a true connoisseur.
So, may I ask what the play you're seeing is about?
Authority, regulations, bureaucracy, the usual concerns of petty individual.
Sounds like my old job.
Ah, to have your plans thwarted by fools. But what can you do? You either ignore it and get on with your life.
Or you go mad.
Yes.
Thank you.
Mad.
Or you could sneak behind their backs and get your own way without them knowing.
The third option. Don't tell anyone. But that's the one I favor.
Me too.
Well, I hope you enjoy the play anyway.
Thank you. I suspect it'll be the last chance I get to see one in quite some time. I have rather a long trip coming up.
6 days is good.
Is that the time? Well, I think I just about survived that journey, driver. There's no need to wait. I shall be getting home by other means. Goodbye!
Goodbye, sir.
Don't know how our 60s peaking go. 1, 2, 3.
That was admirable driving for Mr. Blackwell. Your complete lack of respect for traffic laws proves that you are an awful person and is to be commended.
Thanks. I hate traffic laws.
Yes. I sense you may be the sort of individual we are looking for. Have you ever stolen anything?
I stole some pens.
Ugh.
1,000 pens. From a child with a limp.
Excellent. Then you are to be offered a promotion. Go to the alleyway to the left of the salvage yard in Pagoda. My employer will be anticipating your arrival there. He will explain the details.
Let's go meet Mr. Chan. About a promotion?
You? You look like a cop.
Well, I'm not. See?
Ugh.
Nice one again.
Greetings, driver. You want to make some money?
Stop that! I will fire you, prancing fools!
What do you got in mind? Getaway driving?
Not so fast.
Careful driving?
No!
First, you have to prove yourself. Here is a list of instructions. Follow them, and then report to my salvage yard.
And don't get caught like those knuckleheads did!
Sure thing, Mr. Chan.
Please, call me sir.
Why are you still here?
Okay, so Chan wants me to recover a car from his rival while they're having a shindig. I guess that makes me a party pooper. Huh, I don't think I've ever pooped a party before.
Thank you.
ain't fair that we have to guard this place.
Yeah.
You know, we could sneak off to that other party by the hotel pool.
Maybe. If they started playing some decent music.
And serve up some food.
There's meant to be a barbecue here. They expect me to serve up bird food poisoning in a bun without a barbecue. I didn't train for 2 whole days to be a chef so I could deal with this kind of... Hey, a barbecue! And it's even clean! I won't have to smother everything in ketchup to disguise the taste this time. Now I just need some stuff to cook on it.
Hey!
System blew up. That is the last time I play opera on it. Whoa, you're some kind of electrical whiz. But you're gonna need another record before you can spin the decks.
And kablamo!
Oh, that wasn't meant to happen.
And now I shall bring her back. Shazamablam!
A record? Should I have used Shamazakazoo? Or maybe Krabakadabra? No, that's for making seafood appear. Oh well, I'm sure she's somewhere safe.
Crank it up to 11.
Uh-oh.
He's grooving.
I think the rhythm just got me.
Catch you later.
I like her.
It can only be a matter of days before they find us.
Is that, chicken? Thanks. 30 seconds and these'll be ready to eat. Would you like some chicken tartare?
I'll pass.
Do you not have confidence in his cooking skills?
Do I smell food cooking? I think I do.
Secret car washes?
Get him!
Oh.
Chase, is it true you're a member of a criminal gang now?
Yeah, that's right. I'm working for Chan Chuang.
I can't believe you do that. I admired you, Chase!
It's not real, Frank. I'm undercover, remember? So I can find out where Rex is and arrest him?
Yeah, I knew that.
You don't have to sign that good luck in your new job card anymore.
Listen, Chan asked me to take a car from one of his rivals. He wasn't exactly a nice guy, but he should probably be compensated by the city. Do you think you can get that cleared by someone in charge?
Sure, I can totally do that. I once gave a really important message from the mayor to the mayor.
Oh, okay. I'm sending it over now. See you, Frank.
Completely smashed it up!
But you did deliver it pretty quickly, so I guess I can rely on you. Which is good, because I need you to go to the office at my limo place. The burglar alarm has gone off. I would send Feng or Li, but they're tied up at the moment.
Which is why I told you not to play with skipping ropes during work hours!
What about the old guy who works at your limo company?
I had to fire him for being too familiar with me, which I regret, as he's my father. If you find anyone in there, I want you to deal with them. Do you understand?
Yeah?
Oh, and while you're in there, the people who employ my services value their privacy.
So don't look at my records!
I wouldn't dream of it.
What are they doing in there? One, two...
Stop!
Chase!
Natalia!
I thought Chan's men were after me.
They kinda are. I'm undercover in his gang. Why were you in his office?
I'm trying to find my dad, Chase.
What? Like in a filing cabinet?
No.
That's good.
I mean that just before he disappeared, he was seen getting into a limousine.
One of Chan's?
I think so. But the only stuff I found in Chan's office were empty money bags from Papalardo's.
Papalardo's?
Yeah, the ice cream place with the trucks, you know.
Yeah, I remember. So if Chan's working for Vinny Papalardo's gang, is it Vinny that's working for Rex?
Hey, where are you going?
Chan must be keeping my dad somewhere else.
Stop! It's too risky. I'll find your dad. It's the least I can do.
I am not gonna let you endanger my dad just so you can make up for the past.
That's not
why I want to help you.
See? Chase has a good heart. He just wants to help. That's all. Okay.
What did you find in my office, driver?
Oh, nothing. I think an animal got in and set the alarm off.
Some sort of stubborn mule.
Not again.
This is why I told you not to store carrots in there, idiot!
So don't worry. No one knows you're working for Vinny Papalardo.
Excellent.
What? You looked at my records!
Sorry, I couldn't help it. But wow, Vinny Papalardo is one heck of a criminal.
Maybe so, but unlike me, Vinny Papalardo has quite a temper.
What? I am very mild-mannered! You're fired!
Also, he doesn't trust anyone. Not since Mo, his right-hand man, got arrested.
Huh. Vinny would probably be really grateful to anyone who could help with that.
Oh, yes. You could just steal a prison truck and then pick him up outside the courthouse where he's being sentenced today.
Wait a minute.
You're not thinking about joining his crew, are you?
You're my driver!
Not for much longer. If I can get Mo out of jail, that could be my way into Vinny's gang and get me one step closer to Rex.
Hey, Chase. What you need?
What can you tell me about Vinny Papalardo's right-hand man?
Mo DeLuca? He's not actually a criminal. He's just Vinny's cousin.
So why is he being sentenced?
Let me check. Wow. 412 unpaid parking violations.
Parking tickets? So, I suppose it won't really matter if he doesn't go to jail.
What are you up to, Chase?
Chan is working for Vinny, and I'm pretty sure Vinny is working for Rex. But to get in with Vinny, I'll need him to trust me.
By busting out Mo DeLuca? That doesn't sound very by the book.
It's the only lead I've got. Does the department have a prison transport truck I can borrow?
Maybe. Try Chuck. He's outside the back of the station. I'll tell him you're coming.
This is an emergency. Hey!
Octobring is continuing to miss him. Okay, I'm listening to the audio from... Well, what you can hear on stream, and it does not appear as though there is an echo. But it does also seem as though my voice is... Definitely say quiet as a word. Anyway, that's enough of that. I can do without listening to the stream for most of it.
Hey there, Officer McCain! I've been expecting you.
Great. So do you have a prison transport I can use?
I sure do, but I could get into a lot of trouble for lending it out.
Then maybe there's something I could...
Perfect! You read my mind. Grab that box and follow me.
Okay.
Dump the box down over here. It's a bike I mail order.
Okay, your bike or building wherever you want to use it.
Oh man, they didn't include the wheels. Think
yep,
you can find some spares?
And I need to have 2 wheels. Why would we find 2 wheels? Now that's just 4 wheels. And that. And the sign of the boat. But, wheels. No, there's no wheels as I can see. Get ready. I'll press B to fill in A cancels it. There we go, there's one of the wheels. But yeah, I always get a bit confused at that. But as far as I'm aware, they made very little changes to how it was in the Wii U version. But that really seemed to be affecting me because I played this version for long. I guess I just expect it to be A from other games. B is usually cancel, A is usually boost.
That's one! Find another! It ain't a unicycle!
Yes, we will went through a unicycle. I'm breaking to here and then I set the tower with you.
Find another. Oh, wait. I'm thinking of tricycles. Well, it looks real nice. I wonder if it's safe to ride. Well, I guess there's only one way I'm gonna find out. You should take it out for a spin. Just once round Cherry Tree Hills and Auburn Dock should do. Pretty speedy, and it's still in one piece. A deal is a deal. You'll find the prison transport truck in there.
I mean, get someone.
Insurance details later.
Just a little more.
get in trouble for that.
No, I know.
This ain't the last you've seen of Modaluca. I can do this sentence standing on my head. Thanks to my circus trains.
There's the paperwork. We won't be seeing Modaluca back on the street for at least 8 years. Thanks to those parking tickets. Another job done and the final day of my 36-year-long career finished. And all without a single blemish.
Hey, Pat. I'm here for Modaluca.
Hey, you okay back there, Mr. DeLuca?
I ain't talking to you. Just shut up and take me to Albatross.
If you insist. But I don't really work for the prison, so we can go somewhere else if you like.
What? Oh, man. I knew Vinny'd come through for me. What's your name, kid?
Chase.
Don't know ya? Don't care. Take me to the usual hideout.
Actually, I work for Chan Chuang. But I'm sick of it. I arranged this escape because I want to work for a real criminal.
Ha-ha! Shows you got guts, Chase. Cedar Street. That's where the hideout is.
Looks like they figured out what I'm up to. This might get bumpy.
If it gets me out of an 8-year stretch, you can make it as bumpy as you like. As getaways go, I'd give this one 7 out of 10. That's not bad, kid. I can see why Chan hired you. You're pretty good at driving. You know, this is making me all nostalgic for the time Jimmy Squareleg stuffed me in his trunk and drove me over the border. Happy days. We're getting close. So, do you really want to jump ship to Vinny's crew?
Yeah.
Huh? I might be able to swing something. I mean, you're good with me, kid. But Vinny, he's another case altogether. You're gonna have to do something really special to get in with him.
Whatever it takes, Mr. DeLuca.
Come around the back and let me out.
People can report this.
Thanks.
Mo! You escaped! We was just formulating a plan to bust you out of Albatross for Vinny!
Too late. This kid beat you to it. Now get rid of that truck! Thanks, Chase.
We
I'll be in touch.
Giving a gang one of our police troops for free. Just so we can take out Rex Fury. Not the only thing we'll be doing that could be considered questionable from this cartoon.
Hey, Chase. I think I found your inn with my cousin Vinny.
That was fast. What is it?
My brother-in-law works at the airport. Said they got some shipment of fancy high-tech gizmos in from a security company out east. I know for a fact that Vinny would really like to get his hands on them.
And how do I get my hands on them in the first place?
Ah. Okay. I don't usually like to do jobs myself, but you did me a real solid back at the courthouse. So I'll help you out this once, Meet me in a car park south of the airport.
I'll get right over there.
I feel like pasta.
Right. I'll just turn to that. You're coming back to me. I'll take the pedestrian route. As we head towards this car park. Just running away, clearly, because they know I'm undercover. It's definitely a kid-friendly GTA. Because aside from running over people, and yet they'll be okay, you can't really do anything to make them suffer. Even when you blow up the cars, it's not really an inconvenience for them. But it's still a fun game, still a fun world to explore, you know, the usual. See what this plan is.
I hope Mo doesn't take long.
Hey, Chase! I hope I didn't keep you waiting.
Not at all.
This car is for you. It belongs to my brother, who I don't get on with. So feel free to damage it.
Don't worry. With my driving, that's a guarantee.
And that's the truck you gotta stop. Get in the car.
Still looks absolutely great.
Great. Now floor it. Nice driving, Chase. I think you're gonna be a real asset to the crew. Now get the truck to Vinny's restaurant. He might not know you, but trust me, that shipment will smooth it over nicely.
I've been speaking with the mayor's office, and she says you can do whatever you need to and charge any costs to the department. Whatever it takes to catch Rex Fury.
Your timing couldn't be better. I just took a delivery truck without permission.
Don't worry. I already started a tab for you after Frank told me about the car you took for Chan.
Frank actually passed that on?
Weird.
I'm impressed.
Well, he was gonna try asking Santa, but he checked with me first. I think he's starting to learn from his mistakes. I kinda feel proud of him.
I'll keep you updated if I have to take anything else, Ellie.
Thank you.
Gallardo ran the biggest gang in Lego City. And now, he wanted to see me. His ice cream parlor was a gathering place for local hoodlums. There was Tony one time. So called because he said everything once.
Hey!
I do not believe that he has never said
hello. Polly blindfolds.
No, tell him I can't see him today.
Lucky Pete.
Good to see you. Whoa! Hey, I found the penny.
The crayfish twins.
Sorry, wrong table.
And Mikey spoilers.
Check it out. When you get to the space center, you can knock down a planet from the ceiling to get a secret item.
So meta, honestly. Kinda spoils the end of the game for us.
So what? I amuse you? You think I'm here to make you laugh? You think I'm funny? Funny how?
I'm sorry,
oh,
boss.
Good.
I didn't
get
mean
out
to...
of here and unload that truck.
Hello, Clown.
Hey, you must be Chase. You come highly
Hello,
recommended.
Boss.
I won't forget what you did for my cousin. Oh, ignore the clothes, kid. It's my boy's birthday. I wanted to give him a nice surprise, you know? I've been looking forward to getting my hands on the stuff you got me for some time. They're called color guns, and they're of particular benefit to the less than legitimate fraternity. You know, us guys. Now, I need someone to see if these things really work by stealing the Bell Pepper Emerald from the Lego City Bank in downtown.
Yeah.
You want to put one through its paces?
Well, I've come this far.
That's right. And don't worry about how to use
Stealing
it. I'll have
a
read through these instructions and phone them through to you. Good luck, Chasey.
I'll have another thing for the tab soon. I'm about to break into a bank vault.
Which one?
The Lego City Bank in downtown.
No problem. You need any help getting in?
Sure.
Okay, right. There's an entrance to the sewer in the gardens opposite the bank.
Whoa, wait. Sewer? I can't just walk in the front door?
It's a bank vault. The only way in is via a ventilation hatch on top of it. And the only way to that is via the sewer. Did you expect a red carpet?
No. Fine. Thanks, Ellie.
That's good, Robin. That bank vault turns the Lego City main department to millions upon millions in studs. I'm crazy, no,
what's going on?
Criminal. I'm scared. I think it does. Thank you. sticking to the spot. Suspicious of that activity at all.
I am going to have to shower for a week after this.
Hey, Chase, you in the bank?
I'm in a sewer.
Wow, did you take a wrong turn? I'm kidding. I've been reading the instructions for the color gun.
Yeah?
Yeah, you're gonna need to fill it from a color swapper.
That sounds like an unusual thing to find in the sewer.
I agree. I just have this weird feeling there'll be one down there.
The Lego City PD gets discounts from a dry cleaner.
I really don't want to know how this key ended up in a sewer. I do want to know how come it fits this lock. What a significant looking red panel that is.
Indeed. Very significant.
Why couldn't I learn to swim backstroke? Smells like these pipes are used to carry sprouts.
I
guess that's a color swapper then. The gun's got some kind of green stuff in it now.
Great. Now, if you see any electrical panels which are glowing red, you can shoot them with that thing to turn them on.
Ooh, I saw one back there over a gate.
You know, I've always wanted to see this bell pepper emerald. They say it's as big as your head. Used to belong to some royal dame, but she sold it, because wearing it as a brooch gave her back trouble. I'll be in touch. Chase, I just read some more. Keep a lookout for a red color swapper.
Right, red color swapper.
Whoa, this emerald. It's meant to be the most flawless one in the world. Not like those useless lumps of crystal they get out of the bluebell mine. I mean, they're valuable, but this thing. Whoa!
What? Who tries flushing an air mattress down the toilet?
Mm-hmm.
Adventure games are definitely fun. It depends on whether you want to wait or not, but Skywalker Saga is releasing, I'd say around April, May next year. We can always get into Batman 2 and 3 in the meantime. Those two are very good.
That color swapper.
Once you fill the color gun with red, you can use it to turn off electrical stuff by shooting any green electrical panels. You know, this is actually kind of like the old days when I used to rob banks myself. Except I ain't the one who's risking his neck this time. I'll read up some more.
Oh,
I can almost taste that big old gemstone. The bell pepper emerald is gonna make me a fortune!
You know someone that can handle the sale?
No need. We're stealing it to order. I've been doing some work for a private buyer, and he wants it real bad. So don't mess up. The last guy who messed up? Oh, man. That was a real shame.
What happened?
I couldn't justify employing him anymore, so he's sleeping with the fishes now.
What?
Yeah, he's a night watchman at the aquarium. I'll be in touch.
That is lovely, dude. Some big, bad, meanie, mafia-type gang boss. Yeah, here he is entertaining his kids with clown costumes and getting people into the fire. Into tubs elsewhere. Oh, a nice girl. And into the banquet we go.
I better find the emerald and get out of here before someone catches me.
Hey, Chase! I got to the really good part of the manual. You can use the color gun to turn things silver.
That kind of defeats the point of me robbing a bank, doesn't it?
It's not real silver, but it's close enough to make stuff all shiny and reflective. Useful if there are laser beams around. Capiche?
Yeah, that might be handy in this place.
Great. Just fill it with silver color if you see a swapper, and keep a lookout for the bell pepper emerald. Call me when you get out of the vault.
Huh. Well, the emerald wasn't in there.
Obviously. But still, it nets us a lot of money.
Not in there either.
The lasers have somehow turned invisible. Okay. Yeah.
It's almost like they don't want anyone to take the Emerald.
Nice that we don't have to be 100% accurate with this thing.
A jewel.
Whoever's in here, you are breaking the law.
I think they probably already know that, Phil.
I guess I'm not getting out of here undetected then.
Well, this is just undignified.
Even the guards, who have done nothing wrong. Just doing their job.
Maybe it's part of a combination. That super build needs a lot of bricks. favorite snowplow.
Off we get.
Hey! I was about to rob this place!
Sorry!
I
meant to have this place
crime.
On Tuesdays, but the people listen to me? No! And they call this organized crime.
Got the emerald.
Hey, good work, Chasey boy. I'll send you the location of the drop-off. And if I get any of the jobs, I'll give you a call.
Thanks, Vinny. Got the emerald.
Hey, good work, Chasey boy. I'll send you the location of the drop-off. And if I get any of the jobs, I'll give you a call.
Thanks, Vinny.
Thank you.
fact we jump over them, they don't come down.
There you go. One ridiculously massive emerald. You're welcome.
Huh. Not bad for my first bank job. Only bank job.
Don't get sucked in by the glamour of the lifestyle, Chase.
And, yeah. The guy who took him first does not get...
McCain!
Chief?
So far, you've cost this department an expensive sports car, a prison transport, and a delivery truck full of electronics. Am I missing anything?
The Bell Pepper Emerald?
Huh? What? That thing's worth hundreds of thousands! You're gonna bankrupt us! Why did you do that?
To get in with Vinny Papalardo's gang. Chan was working for him.
You got into Papalardo's gang? We've been trying to pin a crime on him for years! So, you don't need Chan anymore. Okay, I've got a job for you. You're gonna get me photographic evidence against Chan's key gang members. Then we're gonna arrest them. And with a bit of luck, one of them will give us something against Chan.
I'll need to buy a camera then.
You've cost us enough! Just use your communicator's camera. If you can't figure it out, you can call Officer Phillips for help.
Hey, Ellie. Chief said you could help me figure out the camera on my communicator. Now, I didn't even know it had one.
Oh, that's odd. Let me check your device remotely. There's your problem. You're running old software. I'll update it.
That's...
There you go. I even stuck on some new ringtones for you. See?
Thanks. I need to get some evidence against the key players in Chan's outfit.
Easily done. Just get in a good position to observe them and follow the instructions on the camera. It's foolproof.
Ellie? All I got were photos of my face instead of the suspects.
But not Frank proof.
Lovely Frank Fur being his usual self.
That sounded expensive.
Maybe. Well, either way, here's a nice door. Leads into the massive city down there. And of course enough that this is now leading up the road again.
Whoa!
I'd better find out what deals are going down today. If I stake out the noodle bar opposite Chan's scrapyard, I might get lucky and overhear their plans during lunch.
How do you know that word?
Looks like my hunch was right.
Ah, yeah. No problem. Zephyard, have a good one. And thanks for coming along. Incoming.
Okay, gang. It's that time of the week again. We gotta pay up all these guys we've been having steal cars for us, so listen up. Ping, you're meeting Ray on the balcony of the pharmacy. Lee, Bobby's waiting for you in the alley next to Chance. And Feng, you're gonna take delivery of a rare car from Blake at the limo place. If you understand your jobs, then remain perfectly silent. Excellent. Off you go. You know, we'd make a lot more profit if we just stole cars ourselves.
Proof of three crimes in three different locations. How on earth am I going to get photographic evidence against all of them? Wait, what if I wasn't on Earth? If I get on top of the pagoda in the park, I could see all of those meeting points.
A million a day. Because why not? Sounds reasonable enough. No one ever seems to report any crime around here.
I should exercise more.
Let's see if Ping's got to the pharmacy yet.
Picture number one is uploaded. Nice. I really got his bad side. Now we can trace that boat theft back to you, Ping. Next up, Lee in the alleyway.
Right then. We take all photos from here. Okay.
Caught in the act, Lee. Naughty boy. I just need a shot of Feng receiving that stolen car, and I'm done.
Okay. nice photo.
Ah, Fuzzy Wuzzle. That's Fang, but the car's obscured. I need to get a closer shot.
A gate closer shot it is.
That is definitely the stolen car.
Hey, you! Stop that! McCain?
Chief?
I'm looking at the pictures you just uploaded. I don't think anyone's gonna pay you to photograph their wedding, but they'll just about do as evidence.
That was almost a compliment.
Anyway, I've got undercover officers arresting the other gang members you photographed. So if Chan calls you, you know nothing. I don't want anything spooking him until we can get one of his gang members to testify against him.
Yes, Chief.
Press up to take pictures anytime. Unfortunately, you can only take pictures. There's no tunnel cap. You can't do any selfies. Pretty unfortunate.
Driver!
I know nothing!
Don't worry, most of my staff are morons.
But not you! I like you a lot!
Thank you.
Wait, I did that wrong.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, I have a job for you. Get to the Crescent Park Wharf.
Now!
Thank polite you. As ever.
Stop something. You lovable crime boss. Ooh, stop.
Sorry, it's an emergency.
Hey!
Aw, oh, come on!
This in an ice cream
truck.
Well, that wasn't my fault.
Oh, nice strategy, Chase.
Stuff like GTA Saints Row, it doesn't tell us whether the objective is above or below us. Thank you.
Are you there yet?
Yeah.
This job was meant to be for Feng, but I can't find him. Or Li, or Fu, or Ping.
Maybe they're all getting coffee?
Are you saying my coffee is bad?
No! Something's up, and the only men I have left are you. And this bunch of dregs!
So, with all my most trusted employees missing, you're going to have to do the job for me.
What is it?
I'll give you the details later. No one can know about this. Just take my boat from the wharf and get to Apollo Island.
Now!
Apollo Island. We're going for a space ride.
I'm on another job for Chan, and I get the feeling it won't be just a sports car this time. I'm headed to Apollo Island.
What on earth could Rex want Chan to get from there?
No idea. But this feels like a clue to me, Ellie. A big, fat clue. I'll update you once I know more.
Have you got to Apollo Island, driver?
Yes, sir.
Good. I want you to steal a moon buggy.
What?
Well, what did you think I sent you to Apollo Island for? Ice cream?
Would have been nice.
Just get into the space center and steal a moon buggy!
What?
I should find a disguise so I can get into the space center.
Yeah, you should find the disguise to blend in. Not because you need a jetpack for anything later on. Press the button, open the gate. salute any you need for a vehicle.
Maybe I'll even find a spacesuit. That'd be so cool.
Just ignore the obvious fact that there's a criminal breaking into somewhere. It is of no concern. Special assignment number 6 begins.
Sheesh, that is one small step, foreman.
Perfect. While they're all
absolutely
busy working on the shuttle, I can just get to the moon buggy, which is somewhere around
there.
In the middle of the shuttle.
'Cause of course it can never be easy.
Ellie? Chan wants me to take a moon buggy.
Wow.
Yeah, but I can't get to it because it's in the shuttle surrounded by mechanics, and I'm in the control room.
Maybe you can do something to get their attention.
That's the last thing I want, isn't it?
No. Because then they'll have to come to the control room, meaning you can sneak into the hangar.
Okay. I'll just try pressing some buttons then. What's the worst that can happen?
The entire thing seems to blow up. Well, you did say what the worst that could happen. It's just an example.
Having your atoms scrambled by a teleport kind of tickles.
Space rocket for engine test. Confirming safety measures. And yes, handbrake is applied.
That's good to know. They like their safety very much.
So I guess flying a rocket is basically the same as being in a rodeo. Looks like this track's got a hole in it.
Because of course it does. That's not what we need at all. What we need...
Sheesh! I'm glad my watch doesn't take a battery this size.
And safety concerns about rocket, but they're definitely not that interested in it for anything else. Hello, I'm
calculating optimal rocket flight path. Flight path calculated as upwards.
Now to find some way of getting all those workers out of the hangar.
Right. Lovely. Iron Fress. Nice to know that they care about the cockpit of the rocket smelling mice.
I guess destroying those computers wasn't the answer.
Well, clearly. We're just trying to find the... that? Let's go solve the mystery.
SRB nozzle flex bearing. And I'll need another engineer to tell me what the heck an SRB nozzle flex bearing actually is. Is it the cup holder?
Well, I can't help you with that. I don't know myself.
That might get their attention. I hope that vent up there leads to the hangar.
Whoa! Power levels have dropped off the scale. All engineering staff return to the control room and check systems.
Ooh, I wonder if my driving license covers space rockets.
No, 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 it definitely does not.
Ellie, how do I get the moon buggy out of the shuttle?
There should be a button you can press to open its delivery bay.
And that'd need power to work, right?
Yeah. Why?
I think I broke the power supply back there.
And now the control room is full of people.
Right. Hang on. It's okay. There should be some high-powered lasers in the hangar. You can use them to power up the shuttle.
Wow.
Of course.
There is literally nothing you can't find with these online encyclopedias.
Okay. Anything else I should know?
The annual rainfall in Lego City?
Thanks, Ellie.
I could do with that information.
Laser 1, connected.
Laser connected.
Laser 2. Connected. Limited shuttle systems activated.
You have to arrest him. Right then, this will be easy enough. Just gonna cross there.
Hey, that's my car. It's not your car. You are so possessive.
Fine, it's our car, but it isn't his.
Come on!
Yep.
Ant-Man better be waiting for me in the dock!
Alright then, all we've got to do is...
Driver, bad news. My men aren't waiting for you at the dock.
Yeah, I can see that.
They're running late. And by running late, I mean...
Still sat here on their behinds!
Oh, they've actually gone. Who am I going to shout at now?
Not They'll me. Be here soon, right?
I guess so. Just don't let the moon buggy get damaged until they get there. Oh, I'm going out to the street so I can yell at some strangers. See you, driver.
Right, let's just drive around. For a minute. Completely slowly.
Gonna leave a dent.
Attention, this is security. Everyone return to base.
was security we talked with called again? Hasn't done anything wrong for about a minute.
About
Let's
time,
just
guys.
Leave him be. Yeah, sounds about right.
We'll take it from here. Don't follow us.
Well, it's certainly been fun. We've got three more chapters done, so that should conclude this playthrough. Because it's definitely almost 11 o'clock now, and it's time for me to relax with some Farming Simulator. On the Switch, not the Xbox. I like to just relax in bed playing Farming Sim 17. Might be an inferior version of 219. But on the Switch, 19 is definitely the inferior version. Either way, we can. I've got some Farming Simulator 19 being played on the 1st of October. So if you want to see me playing that, you can come along then. Until next time, bye for now.